Hello guys, welcome to this another video tutorial in this channel. Okay, so in this video, let's model this cool looking shape of building in a Revit. Okay, so before we go straight to the tutorial, I would like to ask to everyone, if you like this content, please consider to like, share or subscribe. So it's helped me out a lot, especially everyone updated once I make a video tutorial in this channel. Okay, so the first thing I will do is to open a file or a template. So I go into new default metric, so that is the millimeter template. Okay, so here I am in the millimeter template in my Revit screen. Okay, so the first thing I will do here is to set the reference plane. Okay, so the RP for the shortcut. Okay, and I name this into 1. Okay, RP again, this is the 2, and mm for the shortcut to mirror it in the other side. Okay, and RP again to make it in the other or in this middle of these 3 reference. Okay, so you have 1, 2, 3 reference plane here. Okay, in order to accidentally delete this very important reference plane here, okay, you can select this, and here you can see this pin. Okay, you can select this in automatically lock it. Even you drag it this, you cannot accidentally delete or move it, okay, because this is very important here. Okay, so I just simply set this into let's say 4 meter of each of this 2 reference line. Okay, so that is the total of 8. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is to go into south elevation to set the level also, just only for the guide. Okay, we just always remember this name of the reference. Okay, I just go into south elevation. Okay, select this, and I can create similar. I just use the pick. Okay, and I just simply set it into 4 meter. Okay, so 1 and 3 or 4. Okay. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is to draw now this shape of that very cool looking shape. Okay, so to do that one, okay, I just go into masking inside. Okay, in place mask. Okay, mask 1. Okay, go into set. Okay, and now you can choose the reference plane 1. Okay, and now I just simply start to draw this very simple shape. Okay, I just simply start to draw, because this is 4 meter, I want to start in this part. Okay, and I just simply go here like this. Okay, and like that. Okay, and I just want to cancel it up to that part. Okay, and I just simply use the my arrow key, okay, to adjust it this. Okay, and now you can use the offset now here. Okay, if you already want this shape, you can use the offset. Okay, and now I just want this into 4 meter also. Okay, I want this is equal. Okay, so now I just choose the line to close this mask. Okay, make sure that this is close properly. Okay, and now I just simply draw a line again here. Okay, like this. Okay, and line again in this part. Okay, so now you can select this in close it like this. Okay, so you have already this good shape. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is go into 3D. Okay, to create now a form of this. Okay, create form. Okay, so if you see this is in the wrong direction, okay, you can drag it there. Okay, and you can go into side to make it clear. Okay, so you snap it in the exact reference plane. Okay, So now once you have this pool shape, okay, you just simply go outside the mask, so hit finish. Okay, so now we start to create a wall in this part. Okay, so to do that one, WA for the shortcut. Okay, and I just go into edit type, duplicate. Okay, and I just change this material. Okay, let's say this is white. I just use this gypsum board white. Okay, and I just simply set this into 250. Let's say 250. And okay, and now I just use this pick face. I just simply start to place a wall here. Okay, so now I just simply select this. Okay, copy and paste align to the same place. Okay, while I do that, we can you can see it later. Okay, so now I just simply select this one wall here. I just simply double click it. Okay, you can go into this south elevation. Okay, to spline. Okay, it's better this spline. Okay, to make it a okay, that is the step also. You can do it by creating the spline, so you can adjust it very well. Okay, so that is the tip there. Okay, because sometimes if you are by doing like this, and you can play it like this. Okay, you can also adjust this as you want. Okay, so that is the tips there. Okay, you can hit the tab. Okay, if you want to the same in space into the bottom and the top, and you can do it like that. And now you can hit the tab to select this DE for the shortcut. Okay, and you can change this wall. Okay, I just want to change this into I think this exterior glazing. Okay, I just simply duplicate this. Okay, and hit OK, and now you can go into edit type, and let's check this into none. Okay, hit OK, and you can check the spacing. Hit OK, we can counter check it first by hitting the delete element. Okay, so I think this is okay. I just simply change this into realistic. Okay, so you have you already done in the one side. Okay, so if you have this one grid line here, if you don't want this, you can directly select it this by hitting the tab. Okay, okay, like this, you can hit the tab. Okay, delete and DE, you can delete it this automatically. Okay, so that is the purpose for that one. And you can now adjust this, okay, into the by going into the selecting this, okay, and go into the properties, edit type. Okay, you can adjust it into 1000. Let's fix this into 1250. Okay, okay, that is what I want. And this is 250, but you can play it out actually there. And now I just go into edit type, and you can see if you drag it like this, you can use the vertical one. So you can go into the vertical mullion one. Okay, you can change this into I just want this 50. Okay, 50 by 150 and 50 by 150 mm. Okay, so if you see already there. Okay, so now you need to you can counter check it in the top. Okay, if you cannot see any mullion there, you can go here in architecture and go into the mullion. You can select the top one, and you can select and place the mullion. Okay, so by going here into the mullion and add a mullion here. Okay, so now what I'm going to do next is go into site. Okay, I just want to change this into fine and realistic. Okay, or wireframe for now. I just want to place it this up properly. Okay, by selecting the or command align. Okay, AL for the shortcut. hit the tab, select, you can find it, the dash line there, okay, so automatically going there. So now what I'm going to do next is to select all this, okay, hit the tab, select just only the wall, okay, MM for the shortcut, so that is the purpose of that reference line, okay. So here is not already open, okay, so what I'm going to do is to do it once more, okay. So now you do not create it manually, I think, okay, you just use the pick line, and now you can select this, you see highlighted that one, okay, you can just, you just only select that one, okay, automatically it's going into the other side, okay, so you cannot, so that is the equal, okay. Oops, so this is a very nice already, okay. So now what I'm going to do is to create now this in the top or the bottom one. Okay, so now I simply go into masking inside again. I just use the, you have two options here, okay, but for now I just want to choose the roof one, okay, edit type, always duplicate, okay, and you can choose the category also here. Okay, the same white. Okay, you can adjust it into 250. Okay, and you can select that mask and go into create. Okay, create roof. Okay, so you have already a roof in this part. Okay, of course, you need to create also here, create roof. So it's already okay, so you got already the shape, okay. So now here also you can create now also the roof, or you can use also the roof, okay, like this, okay. So it's very easy to do that one. So we have already the shape. Okay, so now for temporarily, I just command BG, okay. Okay, here in the visibility graphics and model categories, I just simply search the mask. Okay, for now, I just uncheck this, apply, and hit okay. Okay, but the mask is still there. You can go here and check, okay, show mask form and floors. You can select this icon and automatically the mask is disabled, okay, or hide. So now what I'm going to do is go into WA or wall, okay, basic wall, okay. I just use the big line, I just simply set or create one floor here, and now I just simply select this attach top base, okay. And of course, we need to adjust it this up to here. You can use the drag also, but if you see, you cannot place it very well, okay? So to do that one, okay, before you change it or attach this one, you can go into the basic wall, and now you can change automatically in the, let's say, exterior glazing. I want this is different, so this is exterior glazing, duplicate, okay. Okay, I just want this is duplicated. You always duplicate, so you cannot override the existing one, and you cannot encounter the problem, okay. So now what I'm going to do is to double click it this, okay, do it by using this pick line, okay, because here is not working this attach top base. I don't know why it's not working here, okay. VA for the shortcut. Okay. So I think this is okay. So I just simply select this. Now I just want to create some mullion here. Okay. To do that one, okay, you can go directly into the properties, or you can do it by manually placing the mullion again. Okay, so that is the 50 by 50. So you can do it like this, okay, by using the pick. Okay, so we have already the shape to this building. Okay, so it's very cool looking. Okay, so if you create landscape for this one, okay, you can do it also. Okay, so now what I'm going to do next is to go into the south elevation to check it if this is okay. So I think this is all okay. So this is already perfect. Just change it into fine and realistic. Okay, go into 3D, realistic. You can play it all whatever you want. Okay, so now if you want, okay, to create a more design to this one, okay, you can select this, okay, and I just want to copy and paste it align to the same place, okay. But before that, I need to open some family, okay, if you want to create more glass design here, you can go into file, new, okay, family, okay, family templates. Make sure that your family is the same into the project template. Okay, I mean that is also millimeter unit. Okay, so I just want to use this roof base. Okay, metric generic roof base here. Okay, I just want to use this. Okay, and now I just simply draw a void here. Okay, void extrusion. I use the rectangle and I just simply draw like this. Okay, and make sure that you can dimension it and equal this. Okay, including this one. Okay, equal, because this is very important. Okay, DI, just in case if you want to create a glass into the top. Okay, so I just simply set it into W. Okay, and this is W also. Okay, oi, length. Okay, so that is the steps only into 3D. Okay, and hit finish. You need to cut it first this. Okay, you can drag it all the way up and all the way down like this to make it sure, okay, that this, even in the arc shape, this is, this void is working. Okay, and you can go into cut. Okay, use the cut, select the two object. Okay, so this is already void. Okay, and don't forget to save it your project, okay, or family. But for me, I just want to go directly. So now you can go into site, okay, to see it properly like this. And now you can place it this by going into the component and place it here. Okay, so if you go into the 3D, you have already a void there. Okay, you can select it this. Now here in the edit type property, select this or family, sorry, void family, and you can change it this length into 6 m. Okay, 6 m is enough there. Okay, so you have already a void into the top one. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is to select this. Okay, copy, Okay. And before you paste, okay, copy, I just want to hide this. By going here into the eyeglass icon, hide element, okay. And now I just simply paste it here. Oops. Paste it, align to the same place, okay. So now you can adjust it this automatically by going here like this. Okay. Just simply like that for now. Okay, and now I just simply go into the site. Okay. And I just simply use the AL for the shortcut. Okay, snap, okay. Okay. So once this is already okay, you can select it this, make sure that you select the object that you want, okay, like this, and I just simply change this into slope glass glazing, okay, and I just go into edit type and I just simply set the mullion for this one, okay, just set this into mullions, apply, okay, you can go also here. Apply, okay. Okay, so now you can go into this grid one and fix distance you have already there. Okay, so even you cannot place a mullion here, no problem if you use only a grid one. Okay, but if you want, you have a mullion in grid one and grid two, so that you can assign it like this. Okay. So that is already okay for me. So I just unhide the element. Okay. Do not forget to hide, save the project. So you have already this cool looking shape building in Revit. Okay. So now if you want to add a column here, okay, support of this building, okay, I can do it into the another part. Okay. And also the landscaping or site layout of this cool looking shape of building. Okay, so I hope that everyone can follow the easy step what I did in this tutorial, and if you like it, you can consider to subscribe, so it's helped me out a lot, especially everyone updated once I make a video tutorial in this channel. So thank you for watching. See you again in my next video. Bye bye and God bless you all.